मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट सोशल साइंस विद चैप्टर नंबर 1, द प्लैनेट अर्थ एंड द सोलर सिस्टम। वी आर लिविंग ऑन अर्थ, वी ऑल आर लिविंग ऑन अर्थ, वी ऑल नो दैट, बट वी एडेड अ वर्ड विद इट, प्लैनेट। सो इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू हैव अ क्लियर कट मीनिंग ऑफ दिस वर्ड प्लैनेट एंड द सोलर सिस्टम। So these things would be quite clear to you when we will go through the chapter. We can see countless glittering tiny objects in the sky at night. We all know that when we look at the night sky, in that sky, what we see? Glittering, shiny little objects we see. Most of these appear twinkling. They are stars. So what is twinkling means? Twinkling means they have their own light that seems to go on and off. That is twinkling. So those objects that seems to be twinkling, they are stars. The other glittering, the other shiny objects which do not seem to be twinkling may be planets. They are saying they may be planets. They are maybe planets. Those are not twinkling. Those light is not going on and off. During the day, we see the sun, which is also a star. In first paragraph, that is a three-line paragraph, but we have so many words, like we have planet. So these words would be clear to you further in the chapter. All the objects in the sky which appear similar to us are heavenly bodies. So all the objects we see in the sky, they are similar to us. They appear similar to us. Their shape is similar to us. We don't see any rectangle in the sky. We see, what we see? Round shape, oval shape, these shapes we see. So they all are heavenly bodies. To all the objects, those are in the sky, they appear same to us. The name is given heavenly bodies. The sun, the stars, the moon, the planets and other objects are all heavenly or celestial bodies. So we have two names for them. Name number one, heavenly bodies. Number two, celestial bodies. You would be surprised to know that even our earth on which we live is a celestial body, because our earth is also hanging in a universe. So our earth is also a heavenly body. The stars and the planets which we see in the sky are very small part of the vast space, which is limitless. You know, when we look into the sky, when we look up the sky, what we see, you know, endless. There isn't any end. Our eyes have certain limit to see things, but sky doesn't have any limit. It is limitless. So the things, the part of the sky which we are not able to see is universe, whole universe. So that space, that is limitless. It doesn't have any limit. The stars and the planets, they are very small part, very, very, very small part of the space. There are billions of celestial bodies spread over the vast space. So, you know, billions, more than lakhs, crores of celestial bodies, they are in this vast space. They are very, very far away from us. We see sky stars at night. They seem to be very, very tiny to us. Why they seem to so tiny to us? Because they are very, very small. Very, very small. Why they are very, very small? Because they are very, very far from us. So they appear to be very, very small. In reality, they are not small. Hence, we cannot see all of them. The vast, limitless space, which includes all celestial bodies, is called universe. So, one more term we have. vast, limitless space, which includes all celestial bodies, is called universe. This question can come in 1 mark. So, in these 3 paragraphs, so many terms are there, but which terms we are going to remember? And you can underline that also. Number 1, heavenly or celestial bodies. Then, what are stars? Glittering objects with twinkling sight. They are stars. Then, universe. These terms must be clear to you, and you can underline these terms also. Now, moving forward, galaxies. So what are galaxies? You can see in the picture, that black part, what is that? That is space. And in between, you can see dust also, shining light, and you can see shining dots. They are not dots, they are stars. So this is known as a galaxy. That is a cluster that is known as a galaxy. Though there are billions of celestial bodies spread in the vast universe, they are not uniformly distributed in the space. So what is the meaning of these things? It means we know that billions of celestial bodies are there in the vast universe, but they are not uniformly distributed in the space. Means it is not like everywhere equal number of celestial bodies are there. No. The countless stars in the space form huge clusters. What are clusters? I will give you a little example. You can relate it. See, when you go to a certain city, you see that in a particular colony, there are so many houses. Then there is a single road and there are no houses. That means equally distributed nahi hai. That means the houses that are present somewhere, a number of houses, they are forming a cluster. Ek jagah ikattha hona. That is cluster. So, stars are also in huge clusters. One cluster may contain billions of stars. Clusters are not small. Clusters are consists of millions of stars. At one place, millions of stars can be there. Then, after that place, there aren't any stars. And afterwards, again one more cluster can be there, and millions of stars can be there also. All these stars in a cluster are held together by mutual gravitational force. So how those stars are there in clusters? What is the force that is stopping them going away? You know, that is a gravitational force. You know gravitational force? When you throw a ball into the sky or towards the sky, what happens? That ball comes to the ground. Obviously, you jump from somewhere. Where do you land? On the earth. So that means earth's gravitational force is pulling you towards earth. It is not letting you go anywhere in the space. Likewise, there is a force, mutual force, that is a gravitational force that collects all the stars together, that holds all the stars together. Such a huge cluster of billions of stars, along with the giant collection of gas and dust, is called a galaxy. So, huge clusters of billions of stars, along with the giant collection of gas and dust, you can see in the middle of this galaxy, you can see here, what is that? Gas and dust, it is shining. And here you can see the stars, clusters of stars are there. So many stars are there at one place. And afterwards, what you can see, nothing is there. Okay, so this is called a galaxy. So it is all for today. What you are supposed to do, revise all the terms and underline the important things I have told you. Thank you.